Introduction to holding the ultrasound probe and basic principles of ultrasound-guided procedures. In this presentation, we will discuss the proper way to hold the ultrasound probe during scanning and explore the fundamental principles of ultrasound-guided procedures. I am pleased to announce a new exclusive offering on my channel, the Proficiency in Practical Pain Management course, also known as the Practical Class. This course is tailored for pain doctors seeking to develop their skills from the basics in ultrasound or C-arm-guided pain intervention techniques. I will provide essential foundational knowledge and demonstrations through weekly lectures, making this valuable information more affordable. Take advantage of this opportunity to expand your expertise in pain management. Also, Masterclass members will have full access to previous videos and enjoy additional fundamental knowledge. Proper grip and orientation. Grasp the ultrasound probe using your thumb and index finger, similar to how you would hold a pencil. It allows for better control and precision when moving the probe. Rest your middle, ring, and little fingers on the patient's skin to ensure stability and minimize any shaking or unwanted movements. It helps create a stable base and enables you to apply gentle pressure while scanning. Position your hand so that the hypothenia region or your wrist is in contact with the patient's body. It creates a stable pivot point and helps minimize unwanted movements or shaking while scanning. Probe pressure. Apply gentle, even pressure on the probe for good contact with the skin. It will prevent patient discomfort and image distortion. With a stable base established, apply gentle pressure to the patient's skin and glide the probe over the area of interest. The hypothenia region or wrist will act as a support to maintain steadiness and control as you move the probe. Gel application. Creating an aseptic gel for ultrasound procedures can help ensure good visualization while preventing contamination and infection. To prepare a suitable aseptic gel for ultrasound procedures, begin by creating a mixture of liquid chlorhexidine solution and 70% medical alcohol in advance. Once completed, store the mixture in an aseptic bottle to maintain its sterility. When it's time for the ultrasound procedure, carefully pour the premixed chlorhexidine and medical alcohol solution into a sterile bowl on the surgical dressing table. Following this, gradually add chlorhexidine gel to the liquid mixture, adjusting the amount to achieve the ideal consistency for optimal ultrasound scanning. During the ultrasound procedure, it is essential to protect the ultrasound probe from potential damage caused by the strong alcohol content in the aseptic gel. To do this, use a rubber ultrasound probe cover that safeguards the probe's rubber components from erosion or degradation. By following these detailed steps, you can effectively prepare an aseptic gel that provides good visualization during the ultrasound, maintains a sterile environment, and protects the equipment from potential damage. Scanning motion and angle. After preparing the aseptic gel, hold the ultrasound probe and begin scanning to identify the target and adjacent tissues while visualizing the needle simultaneously. For diagnostic purposes, you can employ several techniques to obtain a clear view of the target area. Sliding, gently slide the probe across the skin to locate the object or structure of interest, ensuring good contact between the probe and the skin with the aseptic gel. Tilting, to improve visualization and minimize artifacts, tilt the probe either side to side called lateral tilt or from cranial to caudal called longitudinal tilt. It will help you obtain a better view of the target structure by adjusting the angle of incidence of the ultrasound waves. Rotation, rotate the probe to align the structure of interest for longitudinal, transverse, or oblique views. This technique allows you to examine the target from different perspectives and obtain comprehensive information about its shape, size, and orientation. During a procedure, it's essential to position the probe optimally while leaving enough space for needle insertion. To achieve this, place the probe on the skin, ensuring proper contact with the aseptic gel. Adjust the probe's position to visualize the target structure and adjacent tissues clearly. Identify a suitable entry point for the needle that provides the best visualization of the target and minimizes the risk of damaging adjacent structures. Calculate the path the needle will take under the probe to ensure safe and accurate needle insertion and guidance. Thank you for watching. I will continue in the next video. Stay tuned.